Hello, everyone, and welcome back once again to INFRA. Last time we made our way through the decrepit but very much still beautiful Stahlberg Steelworks, and, well, learned a little bit more, but still leaving a lot up to question. Whole lot of disappearances, whole lot of industrial espionage. And while I'm starting to think that all this may still be ongoing, they talked about tunnels collapsing all over the city, sort of suggesting that maybe there's some plan that's all being set into motion only now. I've been thinking, in the part before last, who was that body that we found in that place? I mean, I don't know if that's, like, just some homeless person that was staying there. Seems unlikely. But let's carry on. Yeah, a whole lot of damage to this place. So if we can't go through there, how are we getting through? There must be another valve somewhere. But the one over here was like, ooh, maybe we can take a use. Oh, and yep, you would be placed right there. There we are. And that should put a stop to that. You are still not moving. So unfortunately, we can't fix that for ourselves. Or maybe we can. This game is honestly an expert at making me feel like I missed something. And, you know, I'm sure that 99% of the time I did. Because so much of this is optional. Ooh.
The Pit Heath Water Treatment Plant. Maybe this place will be different?
Feels strange to have civilization and other people within arm's reach once again, doesn't it? Although it's only now that I'm realizing we are a long way from the car. And given all the shady characters who operate along this river, I'm guessing it's probably already been broken into by now. Sewer pipes 1 and 2. But no key card. Are we finally gonna get to do it? Looks like we're finally gonna get to do it! Yeet! Well, that's annoying. But expected, maybe. Maybe there's a way to turn it off from in here. Come on now. No. We'll save this until we figure this out. Is there like a security room or something? Anything? Oh no. There's gotta be something somewhere. But all these doors are locked. Alright, let's have a step outside so I can actually hear myself think. Okay, we can get under here, which will enable us further access to the grounds. Looks like there's a path that comes up this way. Also, sorry if the wind outside my window is winding. Oh. We could have just used this. Whoever was living up here, though, actually had access to the building. Maybe right here? Oh, wait. Alarm. Key card cannot be used when the alarm is on. Alright. Look at me jumping the gun. If I had known there was a homeless camp that just happened to have the key card to this place, I wouldn't have done that. But then again, we've been taking all kinds of liberties with our job today. Okay, so how would we turn this off? Wow, that wind is really raging out there. There must be... that looks like it might mean something, but there must be some kind of security booth somewhere where we can override this thing. Oh, wow, look, we're right over the pools. Oh, it's a whole facility. It's not just the one building. And this building over here is a different key card. That is the correct one, and the alarm isn't overriding it, so that's good. Oop. But it is in not good shape. Whatever we're gonna do in here, we've gotta do it fast. Okay, maybe we just gotta run over and push the button. Yep, 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 beep. that didn't stop it.
That's not...
Oh wow, your cough will actually interrupt your dialogue. That's somewhat impressive. But not as impressive as this boot tree. I'm gonna be rich. Get a whole garden of these things going, sell them at 30 or 40 bucks a piece, probably even more than that. Maybe if we come around the other side. Okay, this room is still okay. We can grab an orange key card here. I love these like open areas that you just like slowly untangle. This probably would have been easier, but this is still no bueno. And that alarm is still going off. Alright, we'll figure that out a little later. In the meantime, we now have the ability to enter this building. I feel like I'm jumping the gun a lot, but I just don't know what else to do. Right here is another key card. A lot of sealed doorways for a place that's still supposed to be in operation. Cannot mess with that valve. Open this door. Oh, look at this. Ooh, but this tank is drained. Not only drained, it looks like it's been drained for quite some time. So are we not putting out clean water at the rate that we should be? I mean, granted, I wouldn't know the first thing about this stuff. That won't open, but it doesn't look like we can do anything with it anyway. That's the thing, is that, like, this game is just as much learning what the puzzle is as it is solving the puzzle. White card.
That's 9 packs of camera batteries. I have, like, a ton of these things already.
I've said that, I think, in a few Let's Plays, and I think it a lot in Urbex. I just love that, like, exasperated teenage girl tone that he takes with these things. Ooh, laboratory. A white card or a red card will get you into this one. There's complicated stuff going on in here, I think, but only a white card can get me into here.
Can't carry any more of this.
Come on, one more pack of camera batteries, please. That's all I need, and then I can safely say that I've got a full stack of both, which is really more bragging rights than anything. Okay, this is not a sterile work environment. This one's broken. Alright, well, let's see what's going on in the lab, although I'm going to make limited use of my camera. This seems like the kind of place where there would probably be some sort of physical puzzle. And the potential for them to be really complicated is extremely high. Another blue card, I'll just collect these. No problem. Doesn't matter if nobody else has one. Yes, 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 yes.
That makes 10 packs of camera batteries.
We got 10 and 10. We did it. And we didn't get an achievement, but again, I never know if I already had something or not. 5 guidelines for a safer lab. Proper waste storage, failed that. Proper chemical storage, failed that. Proper sample storage, signage, and no food or drink. Well, I guess that's in the eye of the beholder at this point. Maybe we try following this along the wall? No. Oh, security right here, but there's a code. I never know what blends in and what's actually something I can interact with. Okay, so there's gotta be something we can look at somewhere. Let's look at... Ooh, maybe 1986? That's the thing, I'm thinking it's gotta be something in line of sight. This would never work in real life, but here we can get lucky. Well, I'll take it. Now, to what do I owe the room that did this? Somebody, we can't take a picture of that, but somebody has taken out and emptied a file cabinet. They said that they weren't able to reach this place. So, it seems like someone with access didn't want something being found. Yeah, I'm definitely starting to be more and more of the mind that this is a targeted attack on the infrastructure, and it's all happening right now. A decades-long plan being set in motion, finally. There. Ooh. That's damaged. Okay, so pipe one is working, pipe two is not, but do we want to mess with this yet? I guess we probably do? Maybe that's not a good thing. I know there are things you can screw up, like permanently, I think. Oh, this is a thing. Secondary clarifier. Wait. You can't turn on the secondary clarifier when grit classifiers 01 and 02 are off. Okay, so we've got to turn all that stuff on. This is all, like, complicated, but I do love how this game has very, like, physical, practical puzzles. It's not just a series of, like, overly convoluted door codes.
I still have 9 packs.
There's actually a reason for it, and ultimately you can progress without doing a lot of this. Alright, so from where do we even mess with that? There were still sewer pipes 1 and 2. You are not on. There we are. What about the other one then? Should there be another shack somewhere? Or are you both of those? There's a blue door over here. Almost didn't see this. Yeah, that is not supposed to be that way. Lots of improper storage going on here. There's sewer pipe 1 and 2. Even though that's the label that it had on the other thing. So let's do you and you. All this is needed to get that thing moving again. And we can actually see this from right here. Grit classifier 1 and 2. There's actually a lot of things here that still aren't working. And it doesn't look like I can actually use this as an interface. It just tells me what's here and what isn't. Anything else I should know? No? This doesn't open. Somebody had a workplace accident. I'm honestly not sure if that's meant to be an Easter egg or something really bad that we're uncovering. Nom nom nom. A red card. I'm not sure if we had one of those already. And a document. Everything normal? Nothing new? Not funny. Something's wrong with the grit classifier. Slag cargo was sent to the wrong place. It was sent to open sewer. Doesn't matter, that place smells anyway. Grit classifier broke. So this just wasn't getting fixed. Everyone everywhere has complaints. Sometimes it's due to lazy work practices, but other times, these people are basically screaming into the void trying to get things done, and it just isn't happening. Alright, so this can be fixed, but that doesn't work. This can be done, but that doesn't work. Yeah, so how do we make sure this is all working? Interface. Oh, God. I don't even know how to make heads or tails of this. Troubleshooting. It actually does say, warning icon does not disappear when problem is fixed. System may not recognize the change. You might need installation CD to fix the problem. So that could mean we don't need to worry about it, or it could mean we need to rifle through this place to find an installation CD. This is what flash drives are for. I started keeping a flash drive of just, like, all relevant, software, and it's been so useful, so many... Huh. There it is. Boop. Come on. Come on. Oh, we have to open the disk tray. Wow, this is detailed. And place you. Disk drives can only be closed from beneath, just like in real life. And let's repair. There we go. Awesome. Yes. Oh, it is so satisfying when you get something working, but I think this treatment plant is up and running once more. It's just, I don't think we can completely fix it because, like I said, I'm pretty sure we skipped something by doing Morco. Now all that's left is, well, actually pretty much everything that was left before. So can I perhaps mess with this now? Two, no. One, no. I can lead those on, but they're not working. Clarifier P2 will work. Okay, so that's working. There is now one channel that is working. However, the, I'm trying to make sense of this. However, the first one won't work because of the grit classifiers. Which means that maybe stuff could be getting in through that way, because they do merge in the middle. Maybe we want to turn that off for now? Because that first one is not going to get working. Like, it's just not going to happen because it's a friggin' desert. It's a swamp, but, oh wait, there's stuff here as well. Water sampler. Oh, we can test the water. Put beaker under the blue tap, press the red button, wait until the hatch is opened. Okay, let's try mixing you here. You're now filled, and we can put you somewhere, right? Oh, you know what? Maybe we can bring you back to the lab and do something. I have no idea what we would do, so I'm just going to start waving you over stuff. Maybe it's something to do with this? No? Oh, wait, maybe... Oh, these switches look like they do something. There we go. Close. And run. Contaminated water.
Interesting.
That's not good. Well, at least we know now. We need to get one of these things moving again. Maybe there's something to be found at the bottom of this? I mean, this one's obviously not going to move again. Look at all that dirt that it would have to push against. Tell you what, though, I am actually seeing, like, platforms and open gates. Sort of looks like I can maneuver around on these things. Maybe that's just because I can use the other one, though? How would we go about getting this started? I can't even see, but clearly we're meant to climb up there and ride the thing around. Oh, I don't think I've been here yet. I must have missed this door. And of course things are falling apart here as well. Do I really want to start this, knowing that the pipes are all broken and destroyed? This has got to be, yes, grit classifier. With a note. Notice, make sure all steel factory pipes are closed. Open sewer pipes 1 and 2. Only use this if the new grit classifier isn't working. Well, clearly it isn't. But how do I know... How do I know what the steel plant pipes are? You're now open. Oh, I see. Steel factory pipes are labeled differently. Presumably can be found... out and around the building, so they were probably open to begin with. If these are the steel factory pipes... Yep, you guys are it. I should not have opened you to begin with. So if I close you guys, then I should be able to get the grit classifier online again, and therefore pretty much the whole facility, right? So now you are closed. That's looking good. Presumably we don't need the steel factory pipes since there is no more steel factory. Even less so now that we burned it down, and there we go. Well, these things are grit classifying again. So now we should be able to start to use. That should be mostly fine. Just gotta figure out that blower building. Alright, are you gonna... You are moving. Okay, so when that's on, you're moving. It just didn't make a sound. So then where's... Oh, I figured out that you can hold middle click to zoom in. The blower building should be down there somewhere, right? Thankfully, the platforming should be fairly straightforward here. Yep. It's really just waiting. This game's got a lot of, like, almost whimsy to it, doesn't it? Like, it almost feels like... You know those adventure movies from the 80s? Usually some kid navigating a fantasy world and, you know, all the weird characters and situations they encounter along the way, one by one? This game actually almost feels like that in, like, a modern political scandal setting, which may seem like the exact opposite type of thing, like friggin' Tom Clancy meets Neverending Story, but somehow that's the vibe that I get. Now there should, if I'm correct, be something over here. This gate is noticeably open. And this truck is backed up to this gate like they were trying to move something out. I can hear, like, bassy rumbling from inside. And these are some pipes. Wait, we can not open that. That gate is also open. Office open. Yep. And we have our red key card.
Can't carry any more of these.
I'm gonna make sure that nobody can do anything when they get back here. Good thing I'm leaving so many doors open, which is also nice for the raccoons. Blower building. That's gotta be this. The easy to miss solution. There we go, and...
There we go.
We did it. We done fixed this place up good. Mark is really earning his pay today. I think we can all agree on that. Oh look, the Osmo Loot Factory is right there. How fitting that it be located right next to the water treatment. Who knows, maybe they share supply from time to time. But it seems like this place is empty as well. Well, let's start rifling through the stuff and things cabinet. Ooh, a key. An unlabeled key. My favorite type of key. And when we get these before we know where a locked door is, it always means we gotta pay extra attention to whether it plays that sound. That doesn't look like anything important, but I'll let my camera decide. Yeah, I guess everybody's... There we go. Well, I guess everybody's away for the weekend. Locked, 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 as lockers tend to be. But we've got to try them all. There's no way.
I have like a ton of these things already.
That this isn't an Easter egg, but also that there's not even more hidden inside. Look at all these crates of beer. They definitely are sharing. I mean, it's right there. Can you blame them? These are simply bathrooms. I guess we don't have any money. Looks like someone may have been through here as well. Unused plans. This all looks rifled through. but I can't actually open any of it. What's the point of this? And this is locked. Okay, I think we are on the hunt for quite a few keys right now. That door's been blocked. Did somebody not want somebody getting in here? We can't even attempt it. You know, we should be able to dislodge that from our side. It's almost like they didn't want them to be able to respond to what's going on here. That's a lot of warning lights going off in there. Bathroom. Bathroom.
Where is everybody?
Good question, but all these papers are scattered all over the floor. Osmo Loot, 50% discount, so that explains that. Those two slackers at the Pinefell water plant still haven't done their job. I have no idea what the other guy is up to, but the other one, Marco, is just playing some dumb games all day. The red pipes have a serious water contamination problem they need to fix. I don't know what caused it, but these guys really need to get their act together and fix the problem already. We have to keep delivering water from other pumping stations to that area until the problem is dealt with. The new grit classifier 2 just broke, and the secondary clarifier hasn't been maintained in ages. Now the water isn't as clean as it should be. Have the lab guys even tested the water contamination levels lately? I personally haven't heard anything from them in weeks. I'm sure the results have dropped well below acceptable levels by now. Why is no one doing their job anymore? It's been weeks? Beer, beer, and beer. That's all these guys at the lab ever think about. Seriously, I don't even remember the last time I saw them sober. Osmo Loot is everywhere now. Billboards, hot air balloons, spam mail. Not to mention that friggin' brewery next door. And now they're even offering us free beer to keep us quiet? I just can't stand this anymore. We really need to do something about this. And maybe Osmo Loot is, run by Jeff Walter as well.
That makes 10 batteries. Packs of camera batteries.
Yeah, I don't think we're going to be hurting for batteries for quite a long time. We had some complications early on, and it hasn't been an issue since. Give up. You will never find these. Beer caches, drunken teddy bears, binders with useless info, blue papers with white lines, batteries for your fancy camera, premium-grade white papers, colorful mug collections, striped cardboard boxes, delicious chicken and rice meals, and dragons drinking beer. That might be the last thing we haven't discovered. But I love how they're just like, that's the kind of humor this game has, is that like, it has almost a visual shorthand to it, and it just like recognizes and pokes fun at itself constantly. I don't think I have to take pictures of these. I think I just have to find them. There they are. Teddy bears, colorful mugs. Like, this game is just so, like, silly at times, and I love it. It was actually kind of a mindset that I tried to have in certain aspects of the Macy State map. Like, being able to find Horror Baby just in the porta potty. Okay, can we get in here? Oh, we actually can. I just assumed it would be locked. It looked important.
I'm in the water treatment plant control room.
What did they say?
There is nobody in here. I found this large panel with a bunch of lights on it, though.
That must be the water flow monitor.
If I'm reading this right, the water flow has stopped in all tunnels.
That's not good. Carla and Ahmed just got back from the Two Gorges Dam. It's in really bad shape. Now that the water isn't flowing through the tunnels, even more pressure is applied on the dam than usual. Listen, you should come back to the office. We need to get to the bottom of this. If you go through the underpass behind the office, you'll be in the metro station in no time.
I'll be there soon.
We're finally being called back, huh? Ooh, another key. These unlabeled ones are so mysterious. Yeah, pretty bad shape, huh, the Two Gorges Dam? Not as bad as the place I was. Yeah, those three red lights are certainly an understatement for what we went through. But do we actually need to deal with any of this? I don't think so. One last whip around. Alright, there's a locked door somewhere, and we need to get to the bottom of this. It might just be the back door. It is. Oh wait, there's coins right here. I was just doing another once-over. So we can... Okay, so we can get that. Is there any reason why we'd want to? This one's just called Fail. We got three coins. Yep. Oh, they're not staying in the garbage. And one more. Let's just get an iced tea. We're all out. Alright. Oh, look at that. That can't be good. If this is actually killing off wildlife, then it's surely not good for humans. Especially in such large quantities. And that could help explain why. Can't go that way. Even more. So it's not just pouring down through that hatch. It's actually all throughout these waterways. Oh, the game crashed? Huh. Okay, there we go. I was worried we were gonna have a bit of an issue there. I think we're all right.
What the fuck?
Oh, that's like proximity triggered. Okay, so we should figure out what's causing that to... Oh, there's like a thing above the doorway there. Okay, and you're turning on, flashing red. And now there's an alarm sounding, so how do we deal with that?
What is this place?
Oh god, look, it's like the Matrix vision, so you know it's hackers. Oh, I wonder if these are the guys that were referenced before in the Steelworks. Yep, this looks like what you'd expect to find in such a place. I'll take those batteries, thanks.
I don't think I can fit these in my pockets.
I'm sure you could if you tried. More hats. Yeah, you guys have a very eccentric collection in these drawers. Is there a way to turn this off from in here? Okay, there's one right there. Oh, system is armed on. Oh, and there's a map of all doors. And a map of sensors, which we cannot turn off. So there's three total. The one we just came from, the one right here, and another one further on. That doesn't feel good. Blah, blah, blah. Hobo trap one off. Yeah, it's a whole log. And poison. I don't have permission to use this. Well, presumably that's what's in the pipes. You guys are a little bit more serious than hackers. That's like basically terrorism at that point. Jeff Walter, the hero of Stahlberg. Others say otherwise. Stahlberg was literally bombed to the ground in World War II. After the war, many of Stahlberg's citizens were worried about the city's future, and most of them moved out of town. Stahlberg was basically just a pile of ruined buildings. Many of the city's old monuments were severely damaged, and the streets were full of beggars. However, the city saw a glimpse of hope when a young and wealthy entrepreneur, Jeff Walter, founded the Walter Company with plans to rebuild Stahlberg. He hired many of the city's unemployed citizens to help build a better future for the city. It was the company, along with the Bergman Group, Hammer Valley Hydro, and Stahlberg Steel, that finally changed the fate of the city. Walter's contributions to the city made him a legend. The future seemed bright for Stahlberg, with low unemployment and a noticeable growth in population. Then things took a turn for the worse when many of the city's companies started going bankrupt. With Stahlberg Steel's bankruptcy, almost half of Stahlberg's citizens were left without a job, some even homeless. The word some might be an understatement. Jeff Walter mysteriously disappeared shortly after these events, leaving his company in a financial crisis. The company is still in operation, but its ownership is in questionable hands. Now the city's glory days are all but a faint memory, and its citizens have low hopes of it ever being the same again. He disappeared too! Okay, the plot thickens even further. Interesting artwork. There's gotta be a code around here somewhere. Something we can read. Like a post-it or something. Maybe the clock has something to do with it. I mean, it's actually moving. It's second hand. What is it? It's only... Oh, it's already 5 o'clock. Wow, I was gonna say, it's been early in the day all day. Wrong alarm code. You're probably a spy, government agent, or some hobo. Go home and never come here again. Oh, it's right here in the log. Password 6832. That's it. So, from this screen, which displays that you've been locked out, you can see the password input. Okay, 6832. And who's this Laura K? But, alright, we kinda have to floor is lava this thing. Or rather, make sure nobody sees us this thing. That was a game I used to play with my cousins when I was a kid. We would go in one room of the house and had like a... what do you call those things? The thing where you draw on it, it has like magnetic things underneath. Magnetoodles or whatever you call them? Anyways, we would draw a map of the house and trace a path and try to find one where nobody would see us. So we can't open these from here. We can open some of them. We can open but some of them. So all the exterior ones we pretty much can't. Alright, but presumably those are all gonna reset if we're spotted. Alright, so we won't be able to reach that door or the one below without setting them off. This one we can open though. And maybe there's a way to disable these systems? There's one over there. Question is, just how close can we get? Door will remain locked. Do not disturb. Not that I've ever cared before. Sleeping quarters. So they might be here right now. And if so, are incredibly heavy sleepers. Internets. Yeah, so we're like basically guaranteed to set this off, right? Like pretty much. Unless there's some other way to do it. Okay, so we can creep to there. Guaranteed to set it off now, but the doors remain open. Alrighty then. So maybe we can't make our escape, but we can at least prop the door. Boss and his crazy security system. Our boss is a paranoid maniac. I don't know what he's hiding in his computer, but this security system is ridiculous. I mean, all these different codes we have to remember, and poison for God's sake. Seriously, some homeless guy will die in one of these poison traps for sure. He even tried making changes to the software's code himself. Now it's a mess. Yesterday, Anthony was having trouble getting the bathroom door to open, so he had to go out and take a dump into the canal. As revenge, Anthony built a brick wall in front of Boss's office door. He's gonna be so mad when he sees it. Anyway, the new alarm code is 1970, and the sensor code is the same as the numbers on the outside of the building. Don't forget to bring some food and drinks to that LAN party at Chazney Hall. These guys are literally just nerds. The new alarm code is 1970, but the other one worked. So if we do 1970, system is ready to arm. All right, so does that mean that we can... What does that mean? What does that mean for us? The alarms aren't going off anymore. Oh, there's some damage there. Said there's some damage there. You're still gonna go off. But the alarm won't stay on, so to stop the poison, we need to use that other code, which is on the outside of the building. I'll be honest, I don't think I ever used any alternate codes before. I do sort of vaguely remember this, but I think I just got through and moved on. I think I was stuck on this for a long time, actually, somehow. 1245. That's our answer. So we just need to head back here. Come on now. 1245. And now the poison shouldn't trigger anymore. In fact, the sensor shouldn't at all. They do. Yeah. Oh, well. I can certainly see that there's more problems down below. But without opening the door, how can I deal with that? Oh, I see. Now that I put them on, now I can use these. Okay. So those are all disabled. I don't have permission to use poison, but it shouldn't be able to trigger anyway. You know, for hackers, there sure are a lot of gaps in their security. Trusting you here. There we go. On that. Also looks quite bad. Lots of explorables to explore, though. This looks real spooky. Oh, boy. Is that steam or poison? Not that it makes much difference in practice. There's got to be some way to stop that. Anything out here on the patio? A valve? That will surely have something to do with shutting that down. So let's move on and try and figure out where one would place such a thing. No getting back up to street level. I would really like to be able to just hail a cab or something. A public shelter. That must be an echo of this city's Cold War, like, post-war roots. Yeah, this Jeff Walter would almost definitely be dead by now. I'm hearing electricities, so maybe we shouldn't be touching this stuff. I thought I just fell in. There's a whole bunch of folks just kind of living out here. I mean, that's the thing, is that, like, it's not just a gag at a certain point. At a certain point, it is world-building to show you a significant portion of the city is actually homeless. We can't get through there. Some damage to the underside of this bridge.
Let's hope the rebar holds until the repairs.
Let's hope, right? No fishing, no kidding. I'm real worried one of these fences is going to turn out to be electrified.
Intriguing.
Myths of Stahlberg, Legend of the Underground City. Stahlberg has one of the most extensive underground systems in the world. There's everything from parking garages and metro tunnels to waterworks and even grain silos. The netherworld of the city is also subject to many mysteries. Extensive old urban networks like the Stolberg's Underground are bound to have countless stories linked to them, whether those stories are actually real or not. One of the biggest urban legends related to Stolberg's underground infrastructure is the existence of the so-called Underground City of Stolberg. According to legend, the Underground City is a safe haven for the many homeless people of Stolberg. Many different versions of the story circulate with the public. Some say the Underground City is built into a huge cave. Others say it's located in an abandoned mineshaft. Sometimes it's said to be a disused metro tunnel. More often than not, the Underground City is described as the most beautiful place in the world. A place full of waterfalls, brightly colored buildings, friendly people, and overall happiness. A place where everything's well maintained and everyone has their own home. There's also a darker version of the story. Instead of all the happy things, the Underground City is full of dark, wet tunnels, infested with drug users and sick people. Some even say there's a strange cult present where people worship a savage underground deity. The wildest theory suggests that the Underground City is actually a secret community run by the aforementioned cult. In this version of the story, the place is actually a huge psychoactive mushroom farm, where captured homeless people are forced to work in subhuman conditions. There's no real proof that the Underground City of Stolberg actually exists, or if it does, where it's located. The legend says that only the homeless people can enter the Underground City. Some homeless people we interviewed said the entrance to the place might be located in open sewer. Others said it's actually located right under the Stolberg Central Railway Station's lower platform. One man even suggested that it's in fact located in the underground holding cell block of the Furplus police station. No definite consensus of the location could be achieved. All in all, the Underground City of Stolberg remains as one of the biggest mysteries of the city. Maybe the Underground City is just some abandoned mineshaft where a couple of homeless people live. Or maybe it's a beautiful secret bunker built by rich people. No one really seems to know. Oh look, the image up there is captioned as restaurant in a former salt mine. It's almost like the Paris catacombs in the various guerrilla, structures that have been set up down there. I remember the one famous story of a whole working movie theater. Actually, I am seeing a 3D interior to the boss's bricked-off office. Maybe from here I can gain a clue about what I'm supposed to do with the valve? Oh wait. Door. It says here, door WC, unlock failed, unlock failed, unlock failed, and then unlocked. We're really scouring back now. This is, for a puzzle I've already technically solved, we're sure spending a lot of time here. Oh, we just have to try it a bunch of times. Oh my god. Okay, so we really do just have to, mash that one button. I don't know how such a thing is even possible, but we can open it now. Is that laptop actually just balancing on a pipe? Who? Oh my god, Mark, I really hope you're reporting this place to the authorities. That goes down. That's almost certainly where we need to put the thing. Oh my god, animals. Look, I've never even understood people who, use their phone on the toilet. Who's taking this long that you can do anything with it? But this is on another level. This is the circle of life, I suppose. All right, please let me... Please, thank you. Ow. That's stuck. Is there someplace else I'm supposed to use this? Okay, this didn't really help me. Oh, maybe right there? Hang on. There we go. My gaming instincts have trained me that a red valve wheel goes with a red pipe. Alright, well, we've closed that off now, but... What does that do for us? I guess the bridge itself counts as a collectible. I'm not really sure how to move forward unless I really am just supposed to platform off of that barrel that's over there. Unless maybe I can walk in this? Man, this is the kind of thing where we save first. Yep. Oh yeah, no, we can walk in this. Until the very moment that we can't, which is why I'm a little concerned. That drop-off could come suddenly in murky water such as this. Hello? This still allows us access. Ooh, key to the gate and another gate. Remember to return keys. We'll get on that.
Interesting.
This is all from 1983. Yearly inspection, all okay. Problems with sluice controls, blah blah blah. Tunnel and sewer keys missing. Didn't find them, looked everywhere. Strange smell coming from canal. Looking for the keys, protesting at the factory. Keys have reappeared. Remember to return keys, sign added. So somebody took the keys, did something, and then brought them back. Oh, we've got the key to this. Could cross over there. You know, for a narrow canal, this sure is complicated. Whoa.
No wonder it suddenly got so hot.
Yeah, this is quite a thing. All right, we can use this somewhere, I guess. We can't spend time up there. We can close this from here.
That should do it.
Good, excellent, but we still have a problem. There's still smoke. We can lean down. Maybe we can use this. We can't touch any of the metal sides. It's all destroyed. Hang on. That's no good. Wait, what about this down here? All counts as one thing.
Better watch out for those electrified metal parts.
Are we really gonna try this? Like, really? Let's toss you over. This is a time for a save. I don't think I can make this. Can I move any of these things? Yep, there's no way. We're not even close. There's got to be a way to kill the power then, right? But there's got to be something over here. There we go. Another document. Open sewer, or more like open sewer. The most infamous place in Stahlberg region is mostly known for its alcoholics, poor social status, and bad city planning. But is it really as bad as its reputation suggests? This is the real underground city. Now this is interesting. As with everything, Jeff Walter had his hands in this, building low-income housing here. But of course, the place still deteriorated and basically became full of crime and drug use and everything. A partial building collapse in 1993, and the smell of the canals growing worse due to contamination. So basically, this is like the dumping ground for everything that's going wrong in the city. It just took the main city longer to see it, but it became their problem eventually. However, Osmo Loot Beer apparently had its founding here. I guess you consider that a good thing or a bad thing.
Open sewer sounds like a great place.
This place, however, does not. Okay, so you're very damaged. Real damaged. Which one are you? Are you numbered? Let's just shut you off. No? That's not right. You're still on fire. Oh, we could pull a fire alarm.
You should pay me more for this.
And hopefully you're no longer causing issues across the way.
That makes 10 packs of camera batteries.
Yeah, one thing that's really tripping me up is the fact that I never know when I'm moving on and abandoning a puzzle, this is not working. I never know when I'm abandoning a puzzle and when I'm finding the right way around. What, you're not going to consider this something that's broken?
It's not meant to be like that.
Oh wait, there is a note over there. Do not open leak. By the way, I took the valve so you can't open. Okay, so maybe I need to place that over there. It doesn't seem like I should actually touch it though. Yeah, okay, so as illogical as this actually is, I think I actually need to put the valve there and close it, even though that should kill me, and turning off these transformers actually does nothing. So I'm gonna have to reload a save. Alright, good spot for an auto save. Let's place you up there. Again, logically, this should kill me. And stop that. Now, what I don't understand then is, like, why we would want that to be open when the thing is all broken. So, like, what happens if we... No, the exact same... This puzzle is really illogical to me. This is using some real moon logic. Alright, well, we've got that. And now we can... I don't know, do something? Oh, I guess that melted that to death. You have transformers across the way. That couldn't be the solution to this, rather than whatever's going on here? Okay, alright, okie dokie.
Looks like I'm not going that way, then.
Yeah, I'm guessing that's not supposed to be that way. How much neglect does it take for something like that to build up? No, you guys are fine. Nothing back here. Are we getting out of these canals, or can I not hope for such an outcome? By the time I leave any place, I'm definitely sick of looking at it. Well, with the definite exception of the steelworks. No, there's nothing here either. Oh, I see, there's a door. All of this just weaving in and out of, like, residential and commercial. That's the cool thing about all this. Let's grab that ladder. Man, this place isn't just a fire hazard, it's already on fire in a lot of places. Tunnel collapses, things that have been burning for who knows how long. And it's all expected to just work, so there's no one around to see it. Okay, there's definitely more to this. It's just gonna be a matter of figuring out what that thing is. Is this elevator working? There's not even a way to call it. Oh, this stuff works. Broken. Thank you for the label, but we can pick up petrol. Probably put that right here. Oh, this reminds me of like a Garry's Mod puzzle or something. But we can't put it in. Looks like we're missing a battery as well. And there's a brick wedged under this door. I see what we're doing now. We probably need to lift this thing up. Broken, broken, twin brokens, and together we can make something be fixed, maybe. Boop. There we go. And you're not booping enough. Oh, wait. Diesel fuel only. That's petrol. Alright, well, good thing it didn't let me do it. Oh, there's diesel. Come on now. Yep. Funny how these have been just like regular props scattered around all throughout the game, and now they actually have a use. There we go. Okay, you should be good to go now, right? But we haven't even looked in the office yet. If you manage to get through that protest, go tell the city staff to check the sewer where all our waste goes for processing. That runoff ditch didn't like this before. I'm a little confused by that wording, and now everyone is blaming us. The boss even claims that this is sabotage after the failed attempt to take over the company. So there was an attempt to take over this one as well.
I have like a ton of these things already.
We can use some kind of lift. This thing. If we jump down here. No, I just wanted to see if there wasn't maybe something we could crawl into, just trying to be thorough. Yeah, I'm not sure quite what the role of that thing is. But this, we should be able to get going. Oh, we need the keys. Well, there's keys right here. Sewer entrance. And presumably that is the forklift. But what we have needed the sewer entrance for, whatever. You can go right there. And there we go. But we need to move you forward a bit. Oh, look, this thing moves all the way. Maybe we need to use that barrel to push it forward? I mean, that seems a little bit roundabout, but it should be doable. Okay, on. Not sure what we're doing here. Which is the off position? Okay, and we can use that screen to bring it up a bit, although our perspective is going to be somewhat limited. There we go. Okay, so we just need to nudge it in the back, avoiding the railing, and we should be good to go. There you are, pushed forward. Let's turn that off because the noise is annoying. Okay, I guess you're just not gonna stop. And there we go. Problem solved. Anything to photograph? No. Now we're just looking for that sewer entrance. It's weird. We started out so far away off in nature, and for the past while, we've been so intertwined with the city. Key doesn't work there. Devil's Angels, MC Stahlberg. This place has got motorcycle gangs. Your wastes ruin our beer. Ah, so that's the protest they were talking about. It's not an old leftover note from the waterworks protests or the steelworks protests. This is not an open sewer. It's over 25 years and still stinks. Oh my.
I'm pretty sure that's not meant to be like that.
And it's just open too? Well, it looks like they've been having fun in here. Although I could say that interchangeably about just about any location in the game at this point. Might as well take the reload. We've been at 10 out of 10 batteries like this whole time. Wow, this place is heavily vandalized. Don't touch or you will suffer. Okay. Don't use pipe R2. Now open sewer is here. Ah, this is a class uprising. Instruction table, blah, blah, blah. Use this. Wait. Use this if you want to pump water to the mushroom factory. This is broken. Use this if you want to pump water to the sewer. Remember to turn off and on the sewer and factory switch. Oh, and this door right here opens. Oh, we can go backwards. At least for a time. Can we... we can unlock the way, and... Oh, no, this isn't where we were before. It's where we would have liked to have gone before. But at least we have a means of backtracking if we need it. Actually, presumably, this means we need it. All right, here. Yeah, that's not gonna work. But I don't see anything of use. Now you will open. Anything else around the motorcycle club? You can go all the way back here. No way drunken bikers don't fall into the canal every night. And a sober me is pretty likely to fall into one right now. I can't see anything, nor get my footing, but I can see that this is very blocked off. Ooh. We can maybe get down here. That's in danger of collapse, doing you guys a big favor. But beyond that, can't see through. Oh, I see something over there. Another geocache.
Another one.
Oh, what, you're not going to comment on how it's empty? I guess you just expect it at this point. Oh, look. Stop polluting. Well, I guess that tells us that there's a way up there, right? Oh god, are we really gonna hardcore parkour this thing? No, we are not. Thank you very much. Wait, there's something here. Yep, more issues right outside of where those mushrooms are, actually. Okay, so we can turn this on. There's the pumps. But where do we actually even, like, control this from? Oh, well, that's openable. Got the key.
Metro maintenance access. That's convenient.
But
it's locked.
Wow. Huh. You actually said exactly what I was going to. Oh, that's not good.
I have to find a way out of here. Someone should get that
fixed. I mean, take your pick of what to photograph, right? That's not going to open. Oh, perhaps it actually will. Only to an extent, though. Might as well lower you all the way, then. Yeah, you have no problem pushing into the ground, but...
There we go.
You won't push out. Well, I guess closing you is a good thing, then. Means the stuff isn't pumping through the water supply.
I still have 9 packs of batteries left.
Oh, this is awful. Imagine this in VR. Look, all this crud hanging down from the ceiling. I can practically feel the wetness as it brushes off my face. That's the worst. That looks not good. There is an alternate path right here, but it's very, very gross. Oh, look at this. This game, despite being on a 20-year-old engine, certainly makes the most of filling out its environments. Okay, that gets us around to here. There's stuff there. A brick door here. And we can't get through there. So what's the point of this? About this way. It feels so wrong to be standing up while doing this. This looks really not good. Look, that whole pipe is backed up, but we can climb up here. Nope, go, move. And I hate crawling. Everything... Well, when you crawl, everything tends to slow to a crawl. Put it that way. At least the lights are on, though. Which, you know, shows some really skewed priorities when it comes to the design of places like this. Like, yeah, we'll keep it powered and lit 24/7, but, maintenance, that's a no-go.
That makes 10 packs of batteries for the flashlight.
Hmm. Oh, a valve. Can we knock that out? Looks like somebody was doing some makeshift work here. Maybe it'll be useful over here. Yep. Okay, so that probably opens a gate somewhere. I'm not seeing any documents or collectibles. Oh, but you're stuck.
It's blocking the mechanism.
Alright, so I guess we've got to go out there and scrounge around. This is actually making me very much reminiscent of the sewer level in Resident Evil 2 Remake. It's so goopy and there's so many doors and, like, different unlocks. There's a broken wall here. Yeah, a lot of things do. Come on. It wasn't that long, but come on. That's a real annoying place to do that. Gordon Freeman's been through here. Yep.
That should do it.
Should. There we are.
That should do it.
There we go. God, that is the sweetest sound in the world. But not even here. It's especially when it's something you know you didn't have to do, but it feels amazing to hear that. When you pull a lever or turn a valve and you hear that sound and you think, I just did something cool. Okay, you should now be able to get through. I guess at a certain point, it's not even worth documenting all the locations where there's poisonous mushrooms. These barred-off sewer tunnels will never not be creepy to me. Dangerous strong currents when gate is opened. Are we actually supposed to wash ourselves down? I suppose we may not have a choice. You're not gonna... I get it. We're gonna have to push against the current. Yep. We'll open you all the way, and then that door can be opened, right?
There we go.
Okay. Now we can do that. We just gotta brace ourselves against the wall. I suppose that's why the railing is there. There we are. Oh man, I'm so glad to be out of there. Sewer levels are always my least favorite part of any game. That one was actually pretty well designed and mercifully short. But I find that in games, sewer levels are often, like, just a slog to get through. Repetitive environments, not very nice to look at. And in a lot of games, you tend to spend a long time in them, but I believe we're done here. And I think I'm gonna save this for next time. 2 hours recording almost exactly. I've got to start making these shorter, but I've just been so curious on a lot of these things that I always find that I just want to keep going. This game is very addicting like that. It's always that just one more thing I want to look at, you know? And it's the kind of thing that'll keep you playing for hours. And not to mention needing to know the answers to these mysteries. But if you like this video, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe for more creepy and comfy content. If you have any ideas for other videos you think I should do, the best place to suggest that will be at the Discord, which I will link in the description. If you want to try this game out for yourself, that link will also be in the description. If you want to support me on Patreon, that link will be in the description. And as always, I will see you in the next one.